Vsauce! I'm Jake, and on a recent flight, I rewatched the fantastic Christopher Nolan film, Inception. And in the movie, Joseph Gordon-Levitt's character mentions
the Penrose Steps, the infinite staircase.
And that got me thinking about impossible objects, which the Penrose Steps, or impossible staircase, are. So I decided to 3D print some. Impossible objects are shapes that form in an inconsistent way, creating a visual illusion, something that deceives our mind by producing a false impression of reality. And if you played the video game Monument Valley, it is filled with those sorts of illusions. So let's look at a few examples we printed, starting with this is the impossible staircase. An endless loop of steps going up, then back down, then back up, and so on and so forth. At first glance, it seems logical. We understand what a staircase is and how it functions, but it is connected in such a way to create an impossibility. Once we rotate the object, the illusion is revealed. With every impossible object, the most important part is perspective and lighting. It only works if you are looking at it in a very specific way. For the effect to exist in real life, you need to have one eye closed, limiting your depth perception, or be looking at a 2D image through a camera lens like you are right now with this video. And that also applies what we generally think of as a 2D image, one that is drawn. In the February 1958 edition of the British Journal of Psychology, a paper by Lionel and his son Roger Penrose was published describing a creation of theirs, the Penrose Steps, the impossible staircase, a structure that is acceptable as representing a flight of steps, but the connections are such that the picture, as a whole, is inconsistent. Also in their paper, they talk about how two-dimensional drawings can be made to convey the impression of three-dimensional shapes. It can be used to induce contradictory perceptual objects, and no one was better at that or more widely known than M.C. Escher, who 2 years after the Penrose's paper created Ascending and Descending, showcasing that particular impossible object in his work for the first time. And speaking of M.C. Escher, he imagined and drew a multitude of impossible structures and objects. One of my favorites is an object he created called the impossible cube first appeared in Escher's piece, Belvedere. Down at the base of the steps on a bench is a boy holding the cube. And in real life, it looks like this. The beams at the joints are intersecting with the horizontal crossing sections, weaving in front of and behind. If you stare at it long enough, looking at the object as a whole, your mind becomes tricked by what side of the cube is in front and which is in back. That is, until we move it. It is incredibly reminiscent of another type of perspective illusion that I'm pretty sure you've drawn at least once in your life, and that is the Necker cube, which is also in Belvedere at the same boy's feet. It is an ambiguous line drawing. Even though it is a 2D object, its depth changes. Is this the front, or is this? It creates a bistable percept, a perceptual phenomena where there are unpredictable subjective changes, because you need context, or else a shape could be in any orientation. When our perception disagrees with physical reality, we say we have experienced an illusion. A visual illusion is not really there in the image. Our mind makes it real. All of these objects I am showing you have been lit in such a way and filmed in such a way to make it look like they are all on the same plane. That is to say that there is no part of the object out of focus, even though they do have depth. In essence, we are filming a 3D object to look like a 2D object to give the illusion that it is 3D. And one of the best examples of this is probably the most famous impossible object. The impossible triangle, or Penrose triangle, was first created by Swedish artist Oscar Rutersvard in 1934. And separately by the Penroses in that same impossible object paper from the 1950s. In it, they say that the lines of the drawing are connected in such a manner as to produce an impossibility. Yet, here it is. When features or objects are touching, they tend to be viewed at the same distance. It looks like every surface, every connection is on the same plane, creating what appears to be one solid object, even though it isn't. So, what's happening? Impossible objects are perceptual paradoxes, objects which cannot exist. And we tend to use the term visual illusion or optical illusion to describe them, but that's not always correct, because as we discussed before, the cause is beyond our eye. Here we see four large circles with smaller circles filling it in. Okay, nothing too crazy, but what happens if we turn some sections in these circles blue? What do you see? A square, maybe? Even though there are no lines in between the separate larger circles to tell us that there is one. There are no physical boundaries, but yet our mind is making them. Let's look at another example. We have these objects. It looks like there is depth, even though it is a two-dimensional image. If I asked you what those two shapes were, you would probably say two rectangles, with one in front of the other. But looking at it, why does our mind assume this? Why not a rectangle with two squares on top and bottom? Typically, there's a degree of predictability or expectancy from glance to glance in the visual world. Things look as they do because they are, well, what they are. Or are they?
Hey, Jake.
Oh, hey, Eric. We are intentional beings who are projecting our expectations into the future. We usually see what we expect to see. It's empiricism, the philosophical approach that all information is derived from sensory perceptions and experiences. We use information from the past to predict the present. For example, we say this is a table because we were told that this is a table. You don't need to see the legs of it to know that. It has become an object, just like this book is an object. And when taken individually, the words inside of it are objects as well. It's Gestalt psychology. Gestalt in German means shape or form. And in short, Gestalt psychology is that we perceive objects as a whole rather than as parts. Our perceptual system organizes what we see into groups, which brings us to the five grouping laws. The law of nearness or proximity, of similarity, of good continuation, of closure, and the law of common fate. We saw the law of nearness with those four circles, that when certain areas were colored, created a square. It's when objects near each other tend to be seen as one. But the two laws that factor in the most with an impossible object are the laws of good continuation and the law of closure. These two laws can be seen in all three of the impossible objects we looked at, but let's focus on the impossible triangle for the law of good continuation, where the lines of the object come together to be seen as one unit. And with the law of closure, it states that when a figure has a gap, we tend to see it as a closed, complete object, like in the case of the impossible stairs. If you want some more illusions, I would highly recommend checking out Michael's video on the Sydney Opera House illusion on our Dong channel. Things you can do online now, guys. Michael, Kevin, and I are making two videos a week on the Dong channel, and it is full of saucy goodness. There is a link in the description to go give it a look. Now, just for fun, here is one more illusion we made. Not only does it look like an impossible triangle, but something else is happening. It looks like each cube that makes up the triangle is coming straight at us, even though we know it is a trick, so it can't be. We tend to have the visual assumption that objects are more likely to be convex, bulging outwards instead of hollow. And a lot of that effect is accentuated with lighting. Now, these illusions challenge us to disagree with what our mind is seeing. We are aware we are being lied to, but it is hard to pinpoint why. It is that rare moment when we know our brain is wrong, but how do you convince yourself that yourself isn't seeing what it is? Because of what we know, what we've been told, we tend not to question what we see. We rationalize it. If it can't be real, then how is it in front of me? Everything is an illusion. We've just been conditioned to give it a form, to make it an object. And as always, thanks for watching. Oh, hello there. If you've seen seen my videos before, you know I love and use the site Skillshare.com, who are supporting Vsauce by sponsoring this episode. And by checking out Skillshare, you can support my videos as well. They are a wonderful online community that has over 20,000 courses in things like design and photography and production, and I have used them for color correction classes and Photoshop. And if you want to get into 3D modeling and print your own models, then I would highly recommend this introduction to 3D modeling in Blender class. Blender is great because, one, it is free, it's open source, and it's also pretty fully featured, so you can get started right away. The class gives you all the basics you need to learn the software and get creating, and Skillshare was nice enough to give the first 1,000 Vsauce 3 viewers who sign up using the link at the top of the description their first 2 months of a premium subscription for free. Whee! It's a pretty good deal, and I love you. I burped.